Modi came to Guntur and today it's Chandrababu's turn. He's doing his Dharma Porata Diksha at Delhi. Many national leaders are supporting this cause, sir. Manmohan Singh, former Prime Minister, came. Rahul Gandhi, Ahmed Patel, Ghulam Nabi Azad, many leaders, Kejriwal and all. How can this impact the national politics, sir?
Well, there has been an attempt to rally anti-BJP forces on every occasion. We have seen this is not the first opportunity. We have seen it Bengaluru during the swearing-in ceremony of the Karnataka Chief Minister belonging to JDS, Kumaraswamy. Almost the entire galaxy of opposition leaders were present there.
Yes.
And we have seen in Kolkata when Mamata Banerjee organized the Grand Show of Strength. And there likely to be a similar rallies in Delhi and Amaravati sponsored by Arvind Kejriwal and Chandrababu Naidu respectively. So, and meanwhile, there was a similar show of strength in Chennai, where almost all the opposition leaders came to commemorate Karunanidhi. So, the Stalin, that was a place where Stalin proposed the name of Rahul Gandhi to be the Prime Minister. So, the anti-BJP forces are using every opportunity to rally to cement their relations further. So that is an attempt they are doing it, and certainly Chandrababu Naidu's protest in Delhi gave the opposition yet another occasion to express solidarity and show their combined hatred towards Narendra Modi regime. So this has been it. That's number one. Number two, well, the developments which we are witnessing, Narendra Modi grew up on the politics of Gujarati Asmita. So he still promotes the narrative around Gujarati self-pride. So he won the recent Gujarat elections only by projecting Modi and Amit Shah as symbols of Gujarati pride. Otherwise, the kind of decline the BJP has suffered in Gujarat would have ensured the defeat of the party similar to the defeat which they have faced in Rajasthan, Madhya Pradesh and Chhattisgarh. Because in 2014 parliament elections, BJP got edge in as many as 165 assembly segments. Today, in the recent assembly election, they won only 99 seats. In fact, that decline would have been much steeper if BJP has not played this Gujarati Asmita pride.
Yeah.
So, in the country, they are playing this brand of aggressive nationalism. So, anybody and everybody who is opposed to Narendra Modi is called an anti-national. Even law of sedition is misused from Assam to JNU. So, there is an attempt to call anybody who opposes Modi as simply anti-national. So, because Modi is the symbol of nationalism. So, as an antidote to this nationalism, regional leaders like Mamata Banerjee, Chandrababu Naidu are raising the issue of self-pride of the linguistic people. So, we have Bengal, Mamata Banerjee used this Operation CBI to rouse the Bengali pride, and she took to the streets in a big way. And Chandrababu Naidu, through his Delhi protest, called it a fight for self-pride of the Andhra people. So, the regional self-pride is versus aggressive brand of nationalism. So, this will create a challenge for Narendra Modi. Already for the Modi's, BJP's Hindutva politics faces a challenge from the shrewd caste arithmetic affiliation, Mayawati, RJD. All these parties are trying to establish. So, when BJP's Hindutva is challenged by the caste arithmetic, when BJP's aggressive brand of nationalism is challenged by the rousing sentiment of self-pride or regional pride, what we call it, then it will certainly be a challenge. And on the other hand, Modi's aura of invincibility has been broken with the recent assembly elections. And now with the opposition state-level alliances, BJP's election mission also faces a challenge. So, BJP has three strengths. One, its election mission. Two, its politics of Hindu political religious mobilization, what we call as Hindutva. Three, its aggressive brand of nationalism. Modi was presented as a national hero, as a strong national leader. So, on these three counts, you are facing a challenge. The challenge of regional pride, the challenge of caste arithmetic, the challenge of opposition, united opposition, and the challenge of on the corruption front, you're already witnessing narrative on Rafael deal, etc., etc. So the opposition is trying to use every other occasion to rally their forces, to join their forces against Narendra Modi.
And will this continue, sir? Because tomorrow, I think all the opposition parties are trying to meet President Kovind and give a representation. So for in the further coming days also, Mamata Banerjee is trying to hold one more protest in Delhi.
Well, that will happen because even recently, more than 22 parties have joined hands to represent the Election Commission of India on the question of EVMs or at least counting the VVPAT machines. That's what I'm telling. The opposition on the eve of elections are trying to use every event, every occasion, every issue to send a message to the nation that they are united. But my point is such a macro picture, such a big picture, such a photo opportunity will not actually yield electoral dividends.
Yeah.
What delivers electorally, benefits electorally, is the strong anti-BJP alliances at the state level. If the SP, BSP, Congress, RLD can come together in Uttar Pradesh, if Congress, NCP are strongly cohesive in Maharashtra, if Trinamool and Congress come together in Bengal, if Congress and JDF fight together in Karnataka, they will make a difference. Otherwise, these opposition show of unity will remain as a photo opportunity because people in Karnataka, people in Bengal, people in Gudivada, people in Karimnagar will not vote by looking at the big photo that appears in on the television screens and the newspapers in Delhi of opposition unity.
Sir, after seeing the Congress-JDS alliance in Karnataka, and every second day CM Kumaraswamy is making a statement, if you don't want me to continue as CM, I am ready to get down. After looking at this, won't it give strength to the Modi statement calling the alliance as Maha Milawat?
Any alliance is a Maha Milawat. Look at the alliance in Maharashtra. If you read the Shiv Sena's Amna paper, it is a much more bitter critic than anybody else.
Yes.
Shiv Sena is a part of NDA. From Rafael to demonetization. Tell me one single issue where BJP has not questioned, Shiv Sena has not questioned Modi. So there is a within the NDA, Shiv Sena is fighting with BJP. And every week, Gadkari gives a statement that indirectly attacks Modi.
True.
Even when opposition is using it as an ammunition also.
Yes.
Knowing fully well that opposition is using it ammunition, Nitin Gadkari makes it a point to remark, make some comments somewhere so that it becomes a political weapon in the hands of opposition. And yesterday, the Suhail Dev's party, Suhail Dev party, Suhail Dev Bharat Samaj party. This is a party in Uttar Pradesh, based on a community, Suhail Dev community. So it's a small party in Uttar Pradesh, which has couple of MLAs and a minister. So this party is a part of NDA.
Yeah.
And it yesterday itself announced that Mamata Banerjee will be the best prime minister. So what is it? It's an NDA ally. An NDA ally telling Mamata Banerjee will become the best prime minister. RLSP in Bihar, Upendra Kushwaha, he left the NDA. Assam Ganaparishad left the NDA and on the issue of citizenship amendment bill.
Yes.
So the Apnadal in Uttar Pradesh is already raising questions over the NDA. So this is not new with particular coalition. So it is an attempt to portray that the only opposition coalitions are with problems. Coalitions work like coalitions. You can't expect when a political party itself has no unity within itself. We have seen how the Vasundhara Raja and their opponents fought in Rajasthan BJP. We have seen even Arun Jaitley and Rajnath Singh went complained on each other to Narendra Modi. We see Subramanian Swamy making all kinds of statements. We have a BJP MP called Udit Raj, strongly criticizing the BJP stand on Sabarimala. He's a scheduled Dalit leader and a BJP MP. Latest issue of Frontline has a detailed interview with him. Somebody can read it. So he is questioning the Narendra Modi stand on the Sabarimala and stating that women should be allowed. When woman is impure, how can a man who has come from woman's womb be pure? This is what Udit Raj asked. I'm not asking. So this kind of questions are always there. Subramanian Swamy took strong objection to the appointment of RBI governor, not CBI chief. Subramanian Swamy calls them corrupt people also.
Yeah.
So when he's a BJP MP. So then there are problems in every political party. There are problems in every coalition. Let's not exaggerate. Only opposition led alliances have problems and BJP led alliances have no problems.
But sir, maybe my question is far fetched. But if both BJP and Congress stand at the similar number in the forthcoming elections, which national party has got more tendency to attract these parties?
It doesn't depend upon Modi's good looks or Rahul's smartness. It depends upon the arithmetic, post-poll arithmetic.
Okay.
Which political party has numbers? And what is the character of that party? For example, if KCR has more numbers, KCR cannot support Congress. He will not be, the Congress will not be the first priority for him.
Yes.
He may or may not, but he cannot take Congress as the first priority in Delhi, essentially because Congress is his main rival. If you take Mamata Banerjee, when BJP is her main rival, she cannot join hands with BJP. So she would love to prefer Congress first. So it depends on if DMK gets more seats or YSR Congress gets more seats. Well, they can drift to any alliance because for them Congress, neither the Congress nor BJP are main rivals.
Yeah.
If left gets more seats, obviously they won't support BJP.
Yes.
Today they are telling they won't support Congress also. But if they had to prefer between BJP and Congress, they will certainly prefer BJP. We have seen their support to UPA reaching. So it depends on Akhilesh Yadav. He can't support BJP when BJP is in power in his own state of Uttar Pradesh. So if you look at who will come to parliament tomorrow. So it's most likely that the anti-BJP forces are going to be the going to have more MPs within the non-BJP, non-Congress spectrum also. Because Mamata Banerjee, she is expected to win not less than 35 seats. Akhilesh will win a maximum number of seats, at least the substantial number of seats. So if the parties which do not have BJP as their main rival in their respective states have more members, BJP has more chances of attracting. If the parties for which Congress is not a main rival win more MP seats, Congress can attract more.
Yeah.
So, because the regional parties do not have any ideological moorings, regional parties tend to shift stance, shift loyalties. Look at every regional party, DMK or ADMK or even TDP, almost every political party, Akhilesh, Mayawati, Mamata, they are either allied with Congress or allied with the BJP or allied with the both. So they don't have any hesitation. But their stand is determined by their respective political interest. Who is their main rival in their own state? So they would not wish to strengthen their rival in their own state. That is the only stand they will take.